This to new students. Hello.
Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum everybody. My name is Muhammad Ashraf and this is
I'm Edi Saputra.
Undilah kami.
Calon nombor 2.
Okay, so we got already 6 viewers over there. Oh, I forgot to open my YouTube. Okay, never mind. Okay, you can type down here. So we can meet you. Officially, we're going to start in like 5 more minutes. But while waiting for people, I think we can try one question. Yeah, check boleh juga. Relax boleh juga. Eddie dengar kata ada skandal baru dengan satu abad.
Oh, saya setiap kepada yang satu. Maka, oh ya. Waalaikumsalam, Nur Rafika. Dah sarapan belum? Jangan study math. Otak kosong. Alright.
Perut kosong.
Perut kosong.
Itulah, saya bukan cakap pasal otak.
Kena hari tu. Alright.
Okay, tak apa. Kita edit, kita edit.
Alright.
Okay, so while we're not wasting too much time lah kan? Yeah. So, let's try one question while we are waiting for our viewers. Is it okay?
Okay.
Alright.
Okay, so today hari ni, I'll let these two handle. And I'll check on them lah. Kalau mereka buat silap, saya tolak makan PB dia pula lah.
Kami diculik lah.
Great, diculik. Help us.
Okay, so I guess we open one.
Is it?
Ah. Yeah, should be quite fine. Oh, sorry. Okay. So sini boleh. Oh, if you can like on them. Okay, Nurul Afika, KMPP ya. Yeah, we can.
KMPP.
Alright, Nurul Afika. Nanti since you calon yang pertama, you boleh jumpa Sir Rudy dan nanti kita bagi hadiah cabutan bertuah, okay? Yeah, seriously. Yeah, you can come. Saya nak check, saya bawa dah hadiah tu. Yeah, alright. Okay. Nurul Afika, please come and see Sir Rudy for cabutan bertuah.
Okay, let's try our first question.
Yeah, so sebagai mukadimah hari ini, kita akan try this first question. So, kalau nampak soalan macam ni, don't panic. Walaupun dia nampak macam soalan apa very difficult, very panjang, but the worst thing you can do right now is very panic. So, first, what we need to do is read the question very properly to understand what does it want and what information does it provide for us to find a solution. So, if we read this, it written fx equals to this, and at the critical numbers, which is the either the maximum or the minimum point of the x value, is at x equals to 3 over 2 and x equals to 4. And it wants which of the following statement is true about the interval of fx. So if we look at the answer for the question, it basically wants us to determine the increasing intervals, the decreasing intervals of the function. So we already identified the information that has been given to us from the question. So semua okey tak? Semua boleh faham kan setakat sekarang? Ni baru like intro lah.
Untuk membuka mukadimah kita. Alright.
Alright.
Kita boleh start with the solution.
Alright. We'll start with the solution. So, what do we understand about critical numbers? So, critical numbers are basically numbers di mana dy dx equals to 0. Di mana dia punya gradient adalah 0, which is the flat. So, bila dia macam ni, when a graph is like this, this is just a sample graph. This is not the function given. So, dekat graph ni, if we find the dy dx, we are basically finding the gradient of the graph. Kita guna color lain lah. Okay. So, yang merah ni gradient dia at a instantaneous point. So, basically, dia duk kata critical point ni. Critical point ni, alamak apa dia ni? Okay. Critical point ni basically dy dx dia akan sama dengan 0. Which is when the gradient of the graph dia akan jadi 0. So if we see here, sini dok ada nilai gradient dia sebab dia steep, ini lagi curam apa lagi lagi flat, then atas ni is the flattest, which is 0. Okay, So di atas ni dia dy dx equals to 0. So the critical numbers is basically kita nak tahu nilai 3 over 2. Kita tahu yang 3 over 2 and 4 ni happen when the graph dy dx equals to 0. So what do we do now? We setakat sekarang faham tak? Can we proceed? Or do we need further explanation?
You can type down. Okay, boleh.
Go, Eddie.
Boleh. Saya tengok sekejap. Nak juga rasa. Okay, alright.
Alright.
Okay, so Nadirah kata boleh. Jadi kita teruskan. So, okay, faham. First step, what kita perlu buat is we have to find the F inverse, bukan F inverse, sorry. The derivative of the function fx right here. So, let me copy this down, fx. Jadi tengok soalan.
Nurul
Afiqah
further explanation.
Yeah?
Further explanation.
Further explanation. Nurul Afiqah tak faham yang bahagian mana?
Tanya je, lepak je.
Relax.
Nah, ya. Yeah.
I'm not sure which one are you, so saya tak boleh marah.
Tanyalah. Nanti makan kami ditolak juga. Alright, tunggu dia
respond dulu.
So, teruskan.
Okay, so kita nak tahu whether dia increasing or decreasing at an interval of range ni yang dia bagi. So, the critical point. Critical point ni, dia basically a point di mana graph tu nak tukar arah. Ataupun tak boleh kata macam tu juga sebab dia ada cubic graph. Cubic graph dia ada critical point di sini. Sorry, guna color lain. Critical point di sini. Critical point di sini. Boleh kata jugalah dia nak tukar arah sebab ni dia naik ke atas. So dia lalui critical point and then dia turun ke bawah. And then dia lalui critical point, dia naik ke atas balik.
Ini when dy dx equals to 0 lah.
Haa.
Dia ada another critical point. Another critical point will be when dy dx divided by 0. Tapi yang tu jarang keluar dalam exam lah. Is dia macam ice cube kan, yeah. Kalau I show you one lah, kalau dy dx not dividing by zero such as the this one. So, macam kita tengok yang ni, where if you look here, ini tukar arah kan, dia nampak kan, dia naik, dia turun kan, dia naik, dia turun kan. Ini dy dx equals to zero. Kalau macam ni pula, yang this point here, is what is another critical point, this is dy dx, where you divide by zero. But yang the second one ni, dia jarang keluar lah. We call this as undefined critical point. Undefined critical point. But it's very rare, very rare. Even last year punya exam soalan, dia ada yang ni tapi side stats. Dia macam soalan pasir tu, dia macam dia hiraukan. Dia buat yang dy dx equals to zero. Terima kasih, continue.
Okay.
Very good job. Continue.
So, right. Next we'll find the derivative of fx. So, sebelum tu, kalau kita nak tahu graf tu naik ke turun, our first step is we have to find whether the point is either a max or a minimum point. So how do we do that? So we do that by doing the second derivative of fx. Yang kita belajar lebih dari 0, kurang dari 0, lebih for 0 is minimum, because it's a positive value and the negative value is a maximum point. Okay. So the first we need to find the first derivative of fx lah before we can proceed. So we try do the first derivative. 2x squared plus minus 11x plus 12. Bawah ni apa dah? Allah. Okay. Oops.
Okay, continue. Okay.
So, after we find the first derivative, we will proceed to finding the second derivative. So let's begin. Nana. 4x minus 11. Yang derive-derive ni semua boleh dah kot. Semua dah pro dah. So it's basically just guna power rule yang kita dah buat banyak kali. If people already done a lot of tutorial questions and past years, this derivative should be no problem.
Past year kata. You cannot say
yeah. So what do we do now? How do we determine if whether f the second derivative is either a maximum or a minimum point? So if we look here, the question already give us the x values. Okay. Already give us the x values right here. So kita kena faham yang value x yang dia bagi tu adalah pada dy dx equals to 0. Meaning dia critical point. But we just want to know if it's a maximum or a minimum point. So we'll just plug in the nilai x yang dia bagi dekat sini. So f...
For commenting.
Yeah.
This is critical, constructive criticism.
Yeah.
Lain buat jalan kerja kan. Yeah. Kalau comment macam ni, you use different color lah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, hi Kila. Hi Mimi. That's your super senior. She once helped me in KVP as well.
So we'll determine F inverse 3 over 2. So we have F this and F this. And 4 and 4. So ini kalau kita plug in value, kita akan dapat 4 minus, ya Allah, minus 11. So ini akan jadi, berapa ID?
Kami belajar biasa dengan
kalkulator juga. Ya Allah, 5 je lah. Nah. Tak apa. So ini 3 per 2. Go AD. Berapa ni? Ni potong. Potong 2. 6 tolak 11. Sorry. Negative 5.
Negative 5.
Okay. So, untuk nilai ni, dia maximum value ke minimum value?
Sila komen.
Sila komen.
Malah nak tengok jawapan.
How are you going to memorize negative or positive is a maximum or minimum?
Smile.
Take that one.
If you are happy and you know it, you will smile. So bila smile, dia minimum point. Dia lebih dari zero.
Buat suara dengan pelan.
Ah, okay. So bila dia, when you sad, you frown. So dia ada maximum point, which is negativity. So dia less than zero. So ni the general basics lah of the second derivative test tu. So from that logic, we can conclude that yang F 3 per 2 ni, dia akan dapat a local maximum point. Whereas this will get the local minimum point. So, is that okay? Can we proceed? Does everyone understand the where I'm coming from and how things are proceeding. We'll wait for someone to respond. Okay, good. Okay.
Assume this idea pandai jugalah. Okay, there we go.
So this basically nak kata so we just do a number line here, this 3, this 4, 3 over 2, so far so good. Okay, so we do this. And we know that this is the local maximum point. So maksudnya dia akan duduk di maximum point lah. Dan ni dia akan duduk di negative point. Bawah. Sebab dia minimum point. So just assume graph dia macam ni. Contoh. So from this, you can already identify yang from negative infinity, which is right here. Negative infinity. Negative infinity up until 3 over 2. Dia akan increasing, right? Dia akan increasing. Whereas, bila 3 over 2 akan pergi ke 4, dia akan decreasing. Dia akan decreasing. The 4 ke infinity, positive infinity to be precise, dia akan jadi increasing balik. So basically di sini dia dah ada. Okay, excuse me please, I have to attend. Okay, never mind Afika. Thank you for coming. Yeah. The meeting.
Okay.
So we'll padam here. So kalau kita dapat apa finding kita yang macam kat bawah ni, which answer which fits the best to what we have concluded based on the graph tadi. So, kita tahu from negative infinity to 3 over 2, dia akan increasing. So, B dengan D, automatic salah. Sebab ni dia kata decreasing pula. So, we eliminate the yang incorrect.
Objective jawab daripada MRSM. Ini menjawab soalan objective MRSM.
And then kita tengok belakang ni, belakang ni dia kata decreasing interval at 4 infinity. So dia salah sebab kita kata kita dah establish tadi yang kalau 4 until range from 4 until positive infinity dia akan increasing based on the maximum and minimum point that we have found. So this is wrong. C is wrong. A? Betul lah. So sini dia kata 3 over 2 ke 4. So 3 over 2 ke 4 dia memang akan decreasing pun sebab nampak ni dia decrease daripada local maximum ke local minimum. And then from 4 infinity dia akan increasing balik. So dia increase balik. Dia increase, decrease, increase balik. So the
have a mistake.
The correct answer would be A. Yeah, A. Good. I'm Daniel, Nadira, Fakiha, and Arif Izani. Oh, my roommate. Okay.
Tiba.
Alright, so boleh faham kan apa cara nak jawab soalan ni? Dia agak lengthy lah. Sebab kita dah explain kan. Nanti waktu apa exam, benda-benda lah, luki-luki, laka-laka. And you'll get A. So, okay, semua insyaAllah boleh faham kot. The show A. Okay. Alright, so Eddie, would you like to continue?
Yes, let me see the question first.
So, siapa yang ada soalan, you can actually send question to Twitter Suruh Dirujab lah. Okay, if you have any question, send the question to Twitter Suruh Dirujab. And you can even join us if you want to. Okay, so
just inside the lens.
So that's a okay, hantar soalan.
di sini. Peter Serodi sekejap. Sorry, I should have write this one down. Kami terima je. Okay. Yeah. We do live your question. If you have any question, hanya tanya live lah. Kita orang buat. Alhamdulillah tak ada soalan lagi. Tanya boleh lah. Tak boleh lah. Just not hoax lah. It will be more fun. We can discuss together online. Okay. Let's go. Okay, so if you nak hilangkan, tekan ni boleh dihilang lah. Alright. So next question.
Alright. Okay. Soalan ni kan? Okay. So macam nak copy ni. Ambil ni.
Eh, mana? Ah, Control C.
Control C. Oh, okay.
Go down. Then.
Sorry, they are still new. Give them some support. Give them some support. Everybody start to learn, but they're doing quite a good job. I'm impressed. Okay, Eddie.
All right. Assalamualaikum and good morning. My name is Eddie, and today I would like to discuss about the question inequalities. So keep in mind, you cannot run for inequalities. I'm serious. There will be always soalan pasal inequalities dalam mana-mana trial exam PSPM pun. So, all right. Let me take this for a while. Okay. So the first thing you need to do. Disebabkan dia ada negatif, disebabkan dia negatif kat sini, so kita bawa dia ke kiri sebab kita nak jadikan ini kosong. Alright? Alright. And then kita dapat kita dapat x square plus 21.
Jangan suara makin pelan.
X plus 21. X minus 2 plus 6 smaller or equal to 0. Alright? And then after that, kita kena samakan denominator sebab kita nak gabungkan the whole equation. Gabung. Alright? And then how to make the denominator the same? So we need to times with X minus 2 in the 6. So X square plus 21 plus 6x minus 2 equal over x minus 2 smaller or equal to 0. Semua orang faham? Okay, thank you. And then after that, we need to simplify it. So we will get x square plus 6x plus 19. Okay. X minus 2 smaller or equal to 0. Alright. And then kita guna calculator untuk solve. Tapi untuk soalan subjektif, you need to remember that x minus 2, kena tulis kat sini ya, x minus 2 is not equal to 0 ataupun x is not equal to 2. Sebab kalau dia x minus 2 equal to 0 ataupun x equal to 2, dia akan jadi kosong. So, divide by 0. So, the whole equation is not relevant lah. Alright. And then, one more catch. Contoh kalau kita calculate ni guna calculator, simultaneous equation, dia cuma bagi satu jawapan, iaitu x is equal to negative 3. So means x plus 3
plus 9 ke plus 19?
Hehehe.
9.
Okay. Thank you.
It's 9. Oh, okay.
Alright, so x equal to negative 3. So means the x plus 3 sahaja. So what's apa maksud dia kan? Takkan dia ada satu je value. So this maksudnya ada ya, Nadira betul. 9 tadi saya siap tulis.
Kita orang nak cari nak tengok audience Pada dia sebagai
perhatian. Ah, itulah. Saya cuma nak test je.
Kita dah tak pernah salah.
Alright, so X minus 2.
Contoh yeah, thank you Nadira.
Thank you Nadira.
Thank you Nadira.
Contoh kalau ada satu jawapan, maksudnya dia adalah square. Ini. Alright. Okay. Ini equal to X plus 3. X plus 3. X minus 2. Smaller than 0. Alright. Semua orang boleh faham? Okay. So, from this equation, we can tell that X is smaller than 0. Keep in mind. Now, untuk sesiapa yang belum tengok sorori, tengok ya. Dia pasal table. Table ni senang compare to line number. Jadi, mari kita buat cara sorori. X is equal to, from this, we know that X is equal to 3. X, sorry, negative 3.
Boleh. You can padam guna second button tadi. This padam.
Ah, oh, new technology. X equal to negative 3. X equal to 2. Okay. Ini ada 2. So, tulis 2 kali. X equal to negative 3. But it's the same thing lah. And then, kita buat table. Negative infinity. Negative 3. 2. And infinity. Alright. And then, kita buat table. Garis, garis, garis. Because there's two equation, the same two equation, kita kena juga letak dekat tepi. Di sini. So, X plus 3, X plus 3
and write down all the factors
X minus yes. Alright, okay, semua orang boleh faham.
Ni table meter.
This is it's quite long, but compare to the number line, yang ni lebih selamat. Sebab soalan ni memang akan muncul dalam exam nanti. Percayalah, saya dah buat banyak pasti. Alright. Now, untuk memudahkan kerja kita, kita dalam calculator, kita ada satu function ni, calculate dekat bawah alpha tu. So kita substitute formula dia.
Really?
Yes.
Siapa tak tahu?
Dia simple kalau untuk nombor, untuk the, in, this is in between negative infinity dengan negative 3. So kita boleh choose what number that we want to test the whole equation. Jadi saya akan pilih negative 6. Ini cuma test number je tau. Yang ni in between negative 3 dengan 2. So saya ambil negative 1.
Did you use different color for that?
Yeah.
For all three of them. For all yang atas.
Hijau. Negative 6. And then negative 1.
Kat sekolah dulu kita berebut ada pencil color besar-besar kan.
Ini boleh color. Right.
6 tu tak ada lock sikit kan. Letak dah.
Okay. Mana biru. So kita boleh calculate. The not calculate, more like kita test sama ada function ni negatif ataupun positif. So, kalau kita calculate, dia proses dia panjang but selamat. Jadi kalau kita substitute negative 6 ni dalam X, kita dapat value dia negatif. Ini equation sama kan? Jadi dua-dua ni dia punya value sama. So this is also negative. Alright? And then X minus 2, kita substitute negative 6. So negative 6 minus 2 equal to negative juga. So negative 8. And then baru kita sambung ke number test yang seterusnya. Kita substitute negative 1 masuk X. So equal to positive value. Ini pun jadi positive value sebab sama. And then yang X minus 2 minus 1 equal to negative number. Alright. And then to continue, kita substitute ni pula. Masuk sini. kita dapat the whole equation positive. Positive. Alright. And then after that, selepas kita dah buat the whole equation, kita buat macam apa? Equation tambah dan tolak. So kalau negatif tambah negatif jadi positif. Tapi tambah dengan negatif, so this is negative. Jadi titip lah. Negatif. Ah. Now I understand Serodi meaning. Saya sambung.
So.
Alright. Positif-positif jadi positif. Tapi tambah negatif. So dia jadi negatif. And this is positif lah.
Rasa lebih sesuai mystery. Darab.
Yeah, and then we already know we already know that x is smaller than zero. Faham tak kenapa x is smaller than zero, viewer? Okay, kita respond. X is smaller than zero, so the whole equation is smaller than zero. Jadi kita ambil lah yang negatif ni. Okay, so to be more exact, dia negative infinity, negative 3, union, negative, sorry, ni inequality, oh, sorry. Close bracket. Dan ni pun close bracket. Okay, negative 3 dengan negative 1. Sorry, 2.
Dua tak lihat bracket sebab equation tak boleh sama dua.
Ah, betul lah. Silap. Okay. And then this and this is the same, so kita boleh combine it together. So negative infinity dua. Alright. So that's our answer. Let's see if we got the answer or not. If we get the answer. Eh, jangan letak ke atas.
Guna mas.
Ah, guna mas. So, jawapan dia si ha?
Didi.
Eh, sorry. Yakin. Condifen. D. Ah, sudah ni jawab salah. So, C bukan is not the answer.
Kenapa kita tak ambil C? Kenapa kita ambil D, A, D?
Oh, sebab dia inequality. So, maksudnya sekarang ni. Dua tak boleh sama dengan zero. Why? Kalau kita kat atas, x is not equal to 2. Kalau x is equal to 2, dia jadi zero. Kita mana boleh denominator jadi zero? Okay. Dia math error. Okay. So the answer is student jawab salah lah. Okay. So the next question I will give to Ashraf.
Saya nak tambah sikit. Okay, this question sebenarnya there's a small trick over there. Ini kaedah cara lain nak jawab lah kan. Okay, the reason jawapan kita pernah yang ni tadi kan. Okay, the reason kita boleh, if I were to tambah sikit ID-nya style tadi. So yang atas ni, this one. Dia sebab dia is a equal kan. So equal tu sini ke equal. I'll do that one. And for yang bawah ni macam ID cakap, dia tak boleh divide by zero kan. Okay, nak divide by zero, so I do this one lah. So nanti nampak cepat sikit lah. Ini this one kan. Okay, but I would like to highlight this one more on x plus 3. Di sini cara cepat lah. So x plus 3 squared over x minus 2, right? Less or equals to 0. Okay, jadi saya secara cepat, but not many people will nampak. If you nampak ni dalam exam, take it lah kan. This is cara cepat. Okay, tengok yang atas ni. And dia ada squared. So, disebabkan dia ada squared. Dengan lelah lah. Ini super tips ni. But equation yang atas tu, disebabkan dia ada squared. I can say this one is always positive. You agree with me? So, always positive. So, atas tu dah positive. Okay, and then equation, dia less than zero.
Kalau less than zero, is it positive or negative? Less than zero will be negative lah. Okay. So positive, going back, positive divide by what will give you negative? And it means down here it must be negative. Okay. So we can say x minus 2, it must be negative from this connection, from all of this logic that we got. So you can answer from here. So since x minus 2 is must be negative, I can write down here x minus 2 less than 0. So x is less than 2. So by the same, you can, this is sufficient, but you can change this to this if you would like to. Ta-da! Which is a lot faster. But you, when can I apply this method, sir? Bila dia ada this kind of case lah. Bila dia ada always positive or always negative case. It might appear either dia modulus ataupun dia squared. Then you can apply this. Ataupun atas to constant. Let me give you one example. If I give you something like this. If I give you negative 3. Like say x plus 2. Let's take a different number. X plus 5. Let's say more 0. Doesn't matter, equal. What do you think is this, Ashraf? Macam saya cakap tadi.
Yeah. So sebab atas ni negatif, bawah ni has to be negatif.
So atas tu negatif, so?
Atas negatif.
Pasal pada negatif?
Because it has a negative value.
Because it's also a constant.
Yeah.
Dia tak boleh tukar. Always negative. Kalau contoh, kalau saya buat macam ni, macam negative x. What can I say about this time? What about this one? Can I say this one always negative?
No.
No, sebab because x is
variable.
Yes. So we can also say that 3 is a constant. And constant dia tak boleh berubah, so it will be always be always negative lah. So atas ni negative, what else can we do, Ashraf, from here?
So for it to be more than 0, it has the left hand side has to be a positive value.
More than 0, that means it's positive. Slow down your thought. Some people explain your thought very properly. Okay. So and then
for negative to become positive, we must divide by a negative value also.
Yep, so down here need to be a negative as well. So negative over negative equals to positive. Yes, by Nurul Afiqah binti Zulkifli, that's correct. Woo-hoo! Give a clap for her. So down sikit, kita tunjukkan dia. Tiga jejaka, tepuk tangan. Woman, come here. Any woman, please. Get MVP. but to be honest, the reason why I keep to 3 because I'm not sure whether the mic boleh tempuh semua lah. But yeah, you can try. So x less than negative 5. Okay, probably get it. Good technique. Okay, one question. Kalau bawah ni ada equal, should it be close bracket over here, Ashraf?
No, it should not be.
Why not?
Because coming back to the original equation, this is the denominator part.
Yeah, so this is the deno. So you cannot be close to negative 5 lah. Like what? Just now AD terang tadi kan, you cannot divide by 0. Okay, very good. I think we can move on to the next question. Ada lagi kah? Yeah, so paste your question there.
Alright, question.
Okay, so check dulu Twitter, ada soalan tak, ada soalan. You can send question to Twitter, you can also send question to Instagram. I forgot. Oh, ada message request. Oh yeah, kita daripada Bobo. This media is hidden. Okay, Bobo, sorry, saya baru nampak ada soalan. Hi there, Bobo. Apa ni? Would you like to join us? Alamak. Bobo. Saya dapat soalan daripada Twitter. Would you like to join us as well? Okay. So this is the question. Dedeng. Terimalah soalan secara live. Semoga berjaya. So, yeah. Good luck. You like with our life, bro. Nah, kalau boleh jangan tanya host lah. Kesian lah. Kesian kami. I'm gonna be kia.
Alright.
Aqilah, thank you for coming. Yeah, yeah, nice to meet you, Aqilah. And thank you for coming, Aqilah. Very lovely to see you again. Okay, continue.
Okay. Relax. Panic.
The inverse of fx. Okay, and or inverse. And maksudnya kita kata inverse dulu kan?
Ya.
Okay, bobo-bobo segan nak join. Okay, alright.
Oh no. Okay. Main lah.
Technical issue.
Ini. Aish. Guna ni je lah. So dia kata kat sini let gx be the inverse of fx. And dia bagi derivative of fx. Oh, besar sangat ke pula. Okay. Ih, tak puas hati.
Mana tengah apa?
Highlighter ha. Okay, main dah.
Oh, hai, highlighter keluar lah. Ah. Okay, semua lah.
Yeah, sometimes dia tak ada apa-apa lah.
Ni, besar ni.
Tak puas lah.
Real tu.
Dia tengah processing.
Okay. Let gx be the inverse of fx. And given yang ni, Eddie, yang ni kita kata the derivative of fx ke ni kita kata the inverse of fx?
Okay. Sorry. Derivative tu dy dx. Kalau inverse dia guna let u ataupun dalam syllabus kita x negative 1. Tapi kita sebab ni objektif, so kita guna let u sahaja. Senang.
I want to be very clear that people understand the difference between these two. Okay.
Sorry, technical difficulties. Macam itulah kehidupan. Okay. Sometimes you need to type down sikit. Oops.
The computer is shaking. Okay.
Alright. Okay lah. Let's continue.
So I want to be very clear here of the differences between yang f tanda x ni dengan f negative 1 x ni. So this is what we call the derivative. And then this is what we call the inverse. Jangan terconfuse dengan yang tanda ni dengan yang negatif satu ni. Both are very different things yang boleh senang termix lah. Sebab PSPM kan masuk sekali function. Jadi
is that the negative one or the...
Negatif one. Ini the tanda.
Okay, alright.
Okay. So yang ni is the derivative of fx. Then d2 over dx squared gs is equal to tekan kena integrate kot.
Integrate mana?
Ini.
Just let you lah, sebab dia kata let gx be the inverse of fx. Kita let you, kita dapat fx is equal to gx.
Oh tak, ni dia differentiate. Ni bukan inverse.
Sorry.
Dia kata inverse fx, dia tak kata inverse the derivative of fx.
Tak belajar, syllabus tu dah. Rasa tu dah SPM.
Takkan, tu lah takkan ni nak integrate kot.
This is a bit tough.
x being x of fx.
Rule ni wujud ke sir?
Okay lah, sorry, this is, since this is YouTube live for PSPM preparation, I think I can also say maybe outside of syllabus lah kot. Tapi itulah, ego kan. I'll think about this aside, then we move on to the next one first lah. Sorry, right. Bobo. We come back to this one. Sorry, this is YouTube. I should not be letting my ego control me. Okay, alright. So let's try the next question first. We come back. I'll do it this side. You wanted to continue?
Yeah.
We got another question. I want to think first.
Alright. So soalan mana di?
Yang
ini. Mic-nya.
Soalan. Soalan.
So if we look at this question, it has given gx is equals to this function and the g of inverse, this is the inverse, this is not the derivative of gx, this is the inverse of gx, is this, in which x cannot be equal to negative 1. So this row, find the value of constants A and B. So soalan ni dia basically nak kita inverse saja, and then dia nak kita compare answer yang kita dah inverse tu. So we should let u equals to gx. Okay. So u is equals to x plus a over bx plus 1, right? So what do we do now, Eddie?
So we just express x.
Yeah, betul. So we just kena jadikan x tu sebagai sebutan. Baru kita boleh tahu the inverse dia. So kita just bawa my sini. Bx plus 1 goes to x plus a. So, mana live stream tu? Setakat sekarang semua okey ke?
Alright.
Kalau ada soalan sila tanya.
Yeah.
Okay. Ubx plus u goes to x plus a. So dekat sini kita just asingkan yang x tu, sebab kita nak factorize x tu, kita nak dalam sebutan x kan. Jadi a minus u will be equals to u, oh Allah, okay. U will be x minus x, right? X ni kita factorize keluar, u b minus 1, right? U b is minus 1, a minus u. So x will be equals to a minus u over u b minus 1, right? So kalau tengok apa, kita dah asingkan dah. Yang ni basically the inverse of fx lah. Cuma kita perlu ganti balik. Rewrite balik elok-elok baru boleh compare. Kalau tak macam mana nak compare? So a minus x over apa ni, bx minus 1. So we take this and we compare to the original. Allah, ni bukan fx, sorry. Ni gx guys. This is gx, my mistake. G inverse negative 1. So we take this, oh bukan ini, kita ambil ini. Tak boleh crop lah. Tak boleh. So kena salin balik lah. Okay. G negative 1 is equals to x plus 4 over x plus 1, right? Alright. So, kalau tengok sini, kita nak kena compare dia. So, we'll just take yang atas ni kita akan samakan. A minus X will be equals to X plus 4. Kita ambil denominator dengan apa? Betul ke ni? Okay. So kita dapat macam ni. Yeah. Then kita nak compare A minus X dengan X plus 4. So kalau kita letak negatif kat depan, dia akan jadi apa? A minus X kan, dia akan jadi X minus A. Ya. Yeah.
Negatif A.
Sebab
negatif ni positif A. Positif.
Ya.
Betul
lah. Betul lah.
Tak. Ini kan keluarkan negatif. So A ni jadi negatif.
Oh, okay, I see.
Okay. So
ni equation tak betul lah. Okay. So kita nak dia kembali kepada bentuk ni, baru kita nak compare dia senang. So from this, what we do is we just take x minus a equals to x plus 4. So bila x plus a, yang ni kalau dapat macam ni, kita tahu x will be a will be equals to negative 4. Lepas tu, kan kita dah factorize keluar negatif tadi. Okay. So, yang ni kita ambil bx minus 1 equals to x plus 1, right? X plus 1. So kita ambil yang ni sebab dia positif, kita nak compare. Kan tadi kita dah keluar negatif kan? Dan ni kita just kita guna balik, kita kan dah ada negatif kat atas ni. Jadi dia negatif a plus x. Lepas tu negatif kat atas ni dia akan efek yang kat bawah. Sebab kita nak equation tu to be positive, kita nak dia original, kita tak mau ubah dia punya equation tu. Jadi dia akan jadi 1 minus bx equals to x plus 1. So plus 1 plus 1 same. Plus 1 plus 1 same. And then here dia akan jadi sebab dia x nilai positif, dia akan jadi b equals to negative 1. Sebab negative bx equals to x. So b equals to negative 1. I thought we have to make both sides negative. Which side, Nurul Afiqah? Oh, sorry. So, yang ni can be written off as negative x minus a over negative 1 minus, bx. Negatif-negatif akan cancel. So dia akan dapat balik benda yang sama. X minus a over 1 minus bx. So kita basically ambil yang ni lah. Kita compare. yang kita dah buat kat sini. So based on this, we know that A is equals to negative 4 and B is equals to negative 1. So untuk yang ni faham tak? Dia agak mengelirukan sebab dia lain. For A minus X. For A minus X. Afiqah kata A minus X. Kiranya di sini lah kan. So basically kalau kita factorize keluar negatif, dia akan jadi negatif, sorry, ambil color lain. Kalau kita factorize keluar negatif, dia akan jadi A minus X. Sebab kalau kita darab masuk balik, dia akan dapat, oh sorry, dia akan dapat X minus A balik. So daripada sini kita terbitkan yang ni, equation G inverse yang baru. Dia bukan barulah, basically kita darab apa, kita cancel negative off from top and bottom. So X minus A and 1 minus BX. Boleh ke semua setakat ni, okey ke? So kalau kita kembali kepada soalan kita yang tadi ni. Lepas ni, okey.
Boleh?
Soalan graf. Okey. Oops. So, we know here that A is equals to negative 4 and B is equals to negative 1. Ada pilihan jawapan tak? So, jawapan dia C lah. Alright. Semua jadi merah. So untuk yang ni okey tak semua? Ke ada keliru, perlu explanation ke? Sorry, dia pergi tukar colour. Boleh reverse tak? Okey dah. Boleh. Okay. Thank you, Ramlah. Alright. Kalau memang clueless, kalau tak boleh nak buat apa, personally, I as a student, I will just try every single jawapan A, B, C, D tu. Kalau tak ada chance, yeah, kalau tak ada hook. Just kalau tengok terbitan ni, dia nampak lain kan terbitan yang atas ni. Yang ni, yang purple ni. Guna color lain lah.
Okay, I got a question that I think you can try.
Okay.
Okay, we got by Nia Jogin.
Alright.
Okay, question by Nia Jogin. I think this one is doable at the very least. Okay, I'm interested in it. Let me see your question.
Oh, no.
Yeah, okay. Yes. I think this is doable for now. Like I mentioned, yeah, we would love to help, but please don't torture us with hot questions in this moment. yeah, we're trying to help it. Not trying to waste people's time too much. Okay, so. I think this is doable. Nia Jongin, if
Eddy nombor Eddy.
Ah, tak apa. Okay. Aku dah main graf.
Okay, actually, do you want to join us? Nia Jongin, do you want to join us? We can send the link for you to join. May I know which uni are you from? Which college are you from? MPP lah you, okay, taral. Okay, so proceed.
Okay. Google. Okay. Okay. So, question once, okay, first kita extract information dulu daripada soalan. Kita y to the power of 4 is equals to ln 5 x to the power of 5 y kuasa 3. In which x must be more than 0 and y must be more than 0. So, yang ni, please ingat syarat ni. Syarat ni is where most people will slip up and take dua values yang dia bagi. So, remember yang x has to be more than 0 and y has to be more than 0. So, dia nak kita find the value of dy dx, oh, sorry, dy dx when x is equals to 1. So, yang ni is basically subtopic 9.4 iaitu implicit differentiation. So, how do we proceed now? We just... Okay, so we proceed by differentiating the given equation kat atas ni. So yeah, given kita dia bagi x kuasa 4 equals to ln x kuasa 5 y kuasa 3 double bracket. Okay, so we differentiate dulu macam biasa. So for y, actually kita boleh simplify benda ni. Kita simplify dulu lah sebab apa dia lagi pening kalau kita try differentiate dua pembelih hubah sekali. So y kuasa 4 is will be equals to, oh sorry, ln x to the power of 5 dengan plus ln y to the power, right? So we can take this to the next level by putting this in front and making our lives much easier. Okay. So basically the 5 ln x plus 3 ln y. So make the question easier, make the question much more senang di digest dan faham. Baru tak panic waktu the exam. So sini kena dapat for y kuasa 3. And remember this is y and we are kita duk buat differentiation to the respect of x sebab dia dy dx, right? So kita di respect to the x. So ni dy dx. Okay. Don't forget the dy dx. Lepas tu ni 5 is a constant, kita boleh ignore. So we just differentiate ln x. So dia akan jadi 5 1 over x. Ni plus 3 1 over y. Tapi jangan lupa dy over dx. Okay. So next what do we do? So first kita simplify dulu lah equation ni sebab dia agak pening. So for y cube dy dx equals to 5 over so, x.
Ada soalan hantar kat IG? Macam mana?
Boleh hantar IG,
sir? Huh? Boleh lejap. Dy
dx.
So, we just bring this to the other side. For y kuasa 3. Tolak 3 over y. Sini kita factorize keluar dy dx. Equals to 5 over x.
I haven't get any IG question.
Alright.
Alright.
Ali, nanti boleh send dekat Instagram.
Okay. So setakat ni faham tak? Setakat ni boleh catch up tak?
Sorry, baru muncul.
Kita zoom out sikit. Baru nampak the scope. So setakat step ni semua okay tak? For how we got to this point.
Jadi saya send kat phone sang.
Okay, so I assume okay lah kot sebab apa ni just differentiating. So we'll continue. Faham, okay, thank you. Ramlah. Mana main E ni? Pelik aku.
It's okay, don't be nervous. Okay. Nah.
Okay.
E. Mm-hmm.
sebab kita continue dulu. So dia akan, so ni basically kita buat main sini. Jadi 5 over x dibahagikan dengan 4 3 tolak 3 over y equals to dy over dx. So jangan menyusahkan hidup dan sila ganti siap-siap nilai y kat sini. Sebab tak ada nak apa, nak simplify fraction ni lagi, nak kena apa input value lagi, lepas tu dia agak pening lah. So better just do on the go terus. So we'll get here 4 1 kuasa 3 3 over 1. So ni akan equals to 4 minus 3. So dia akan dapat 1. So dy dx akan dapat 5 over x. Ha. Tu dia jawapan semua ada E. Where do we get this E? Maybe kena buat macam ni. E y kuasa 4 equals to x kuasa 5 y kuasa 3. Maybe you want us to do like this. So kalau guna kaedah ni tak boleh ke?
That looks like a normal question.
Yeah,
I'll do that way. Not a problem.
Saya hiran tapi, E ni main kat mana?
E?
Haa, semua jawapan ada E.
I think I've done this question.
Kau kena buat macam ni.
Do you mind if I try?
Ya. Yeah.
Do you mind if I try? So yeah, let me retry it again. Yeah, that more than edible. Y4 non x. Tak apa. Habis-habis kita delete video. give them a try lah. Kita niat tolong orang je, don't worry. Jangan pengen fikir lebih. Sorry ya, I am going to my aggressive mood. It's a matter of can we substitute back somewhere lah. So, diff. Tadi Ashraf dah explain banyak kan, so I'm not gonna sembang banyak sangat. Yeah, Ashraf did good. Yeah, all right. Okay, and this equation belah kiri ni, you can rewrite it as a 4y4, right? Ashraf. Samakan, basically, kita samakan penyebut ni lah.
Oh, by 4 lah.
Kenapa tak input saja value y kat situ, sir?
So nak transfer sekejap. No, because I was wondering, because y4 is long. Sebab kita, you want dapat e kan tadi kan? And we found that this one. So I can replace it with this lah. Eh, sorry. Not that one. This one. Y cube, right?
Yeah.
Maybe. We do not know yet. Because soalan jawapan dia ada Y cube. And then dy dx, find dy dx when is y equals to 1.
Yeah.
So that's my normal color. Yang favorite color saya. Tak ada eh, terpotong, terbuang. Maroon. So whoa. And y equals to 1. 4 ln x 5 1. Yeah, still there. Minus 3. 1. Sorry, yeah, overdrive. Someone call me. Okay, start, guys. Sorry, ah. Tengah susah ni. Nah, I mean, people have their crazy moments. This is mine. Tak tahu. Tak ada answer. Let me write and then lost kit.
Jadi bukan yang itu sih ya.
Dapat ini g x. Yang ni tadi kan. Yes, 5 you can transfer in front. I mean the 5 transfer and we can cancel this one off. Alah, tak boleh lah. Okay. Sorry lah, siapa tak nampak mana mayanya eksponen lah. Jawapan pelik, jawapan dia nak eksponen. What about if eksponen both sides?
Saya try di sini.
Apa? Susah lah. This year yang soalan agak susah lah.
Daripada
internet. Eh, main. Dia main, we. Ada soalan menarik, guys. When y equals to 1, oh, sini ada x. Ah, Ashraf, I saw it already. Okay. So, okay, guys. When x equals to 1. Whew, this is very difficult. Well, there are many ways to look at it. So when x equals to 1, I got myself y4 ln x5. Sorry, y equals to 1. My goodness. Mencabar. Berpeluh lah soalan apa ni. And then we exponent both sides lah. And then we respond to both sides, dapat E1. Yeah. It's good practice for now. X kan? Yeah.
Amazing.
This is one. Siapa tahu soalan bobo-bobo ni? Tabat dah. Okay, Bobo, if you are still there, we got for you. E15, right? So jawapan dia C. Sorry for taking your time. Yeah, C. This is very good, very hangat lah. Ultra pedas lah soalan ni, I can say for sure lah. Allahu Akbar. Sorry viewers, if we lost you, I'll try to re-explain again. Okay, soalan ni ultra pedas, sorry. This is a very very tough one, I think we need to retrace ourselves a bit. We ourselves pun pening, so. Okay, guys, let's have a look. Ultra pedas. Okay, dia mula-mula simple je. Suruh differentiate kan. So once you can differentiate straight away, or you can factorize it out. Jadi Ashraf dah buat banyak dah. So Y4, it is quite good. Dia pecahkan dulu guna logarithmnya rules ln AB. Ashraf, you want to continue? Okay, just explain properly balik lah. Kasihan lah. Soalan tadi saya kursi kan. Boleh explain lagi?
So, thank you viewers buat bagi soalan yang sangat mencabar. Even Sarudi, very angry. So, kita dah explain tadi sebenarnya. So, ni kita differentiate. Dapat 4y ni dy dx. 5 over x. 3 over y dy dx. Sorry for the very ugly handwriting.
It's fine.
I'm not fine. So ni simplify. Terdapat yang apa? Terdapat 4y kos 4 tolak 3 over y dy over dx equals to 5 over x. So ini tadi kita dah buat dah sebenarnya. So yang ni just input value y equals to 1.
dia akan dapat lah dydx, betul lah, y equals to 1, dia akan dapat 1 balik. So dydx will equals to 5 over x. Ini betul dah, ini the first part of the question. Cuma yang ni memang betul dydx, tapi yang ni adalah sebutan x, dia nak adalah sebutan e ni. So how do we do? So kalau macam kita ikut Serudi buat tadi, dia basically kita ambil balik original equation ni yang kita just take this, copy, turun-turun and then paste. Allah. Alright. So di sini pun kita boleh sebenarnya substitute value y equals to 1. Penik-penik. Y equals to 1. So ini kita substitute saja. Jangan panik guys. Panik is the worst option to do right now. So 5, then 1, also 3. Okay. So ni kita akan dapat 1 equals to ln ni h. Kita dapat ln x to the power of 5. Kan? So kita guna prinsip of logarithm. Kita buat ni di depan. So kita just simplify. Dia akan dapat 1 over x will be equals to ln x. Ln x, right? So sini dah ada e kat bawah ni. Kita just e equals to 1/5 equals to x. So ha, tu dia. Kita dah dapat the other missing piece yang apa tadi kita nak cari-cari, kan? Sebab tadi kita dah cari dah. Tapi yang tu adalah sebutan x. Soalan minta adalah sebutan apa, dia tak mau x. Dia nak kita cari sampai habis. Cari sampai dapat e terus. So dia akan dapat 5. Kalau kita ambil equation ni, equation 2 and equation 1, just sub 2 into 1. So dia akan dapat 5 over e to the power of 1 over 5. Okay. So ni akan dapat 5 e kuasa negatif 1/5. So just go back to the question. And sini, ini A ni nampak close, but A is not the answer, don't be tricked. Sebab kita akan flip dia akan jadi negatif kat sini. So jangan tertipu, jawapan dia bukan A, jawapan dia adalah C. Okay. So boleh everyone, agak pening menghidupkan.
Are you still alive?
Are you still alive? What Ron Sirodi say? Tak apa, lepas tweet dah, boleh dead. Tweet dead terus.
Saya gantikan.
Okay, go Eddie.
Okay, disebabkan saudara Ashraf banyak kali explain tadi, saya akan explain.
Saya bagi diambang maut, diambang maut.
Tak nampak saya. Tadi ada student hantar soalan, jadi saya akan send kat sini lah, ya. Mana dia punya mouse tadi dia. Okay, sekejap ya. Mana tak soalan yang tadi pelajar bagi tu? Bukan ini. Saya.
Okay. Ada budak hantar apa soalan kat Twitter. So, ambil dulu lah soalan. Mana soalan bobo-bobo tu kau?
Bobo.
Ambil balik lah.
Mencabar ya. Saya. Tak apalah. Okay. Kita buat soalan dulu. Pasal nanti saya cuba cari soalan yang lain satu tu ya.
Bo.
Okay, set.
Tak apa, chill tak guys. Jangan stress. Esok nak exam ni. Tak boleh stress.
Itulah. Siap nanti. Set. Sudah hilang.
Okay, now kita buat satu ya. Jadi kat sini fx equal to 2 over x. So the first approach is the first approach is fx is equal to 2 over x. Right? Okay. And then
ready.
Yeah.
Ready.
And then you can see that the kita keluar kat information fx equal to gx. So equal to x plus 1 equal to x square minus x. Dia ada dua method untuk cari soalan macam ni tau. Tapi saya akan jelaskan nanti. Tapi untuk soalan yang macam ni, fx apa fx dia kat luar. So kita just substitute value 2 over x ni dekat sini.
Ni right.
And then kita dapat 2 over x divide by g x equal to x plus 1 x square minus x.
F tanda x.
Alright. And then kita kena express gx ni sebab dalam soalan dia kata they want to find the function of gx. Semua orang okay? Semua orang faham? Yes, Nur Afika. Thank you. About awake and alive. Great. And then kita nak cari gx. So kita our okay. So kita nak express gx ni. Now kita tarik ni ke atas. Gx no. Tak jelas. Okay. Gx x plus 1 darab. Ini pun tarik ke atas. So 2 over x x square minus x. Right. And then kalau 2 over x, x tu kita boleh naikkan ke atas. Tapi secara x power negative 1. Now 2x negative 1 x square minus x equal to g x x plus 1. And ni kita dari tadi, saya dari tadi dah cakap kan bahawa kita kena express gx. So kita tarik ini ke bawah. Kita dapat 2x minus 1 x square minus x x plus 1 equal to gx. So kerja kita dah jadi mudah. Kita cuma kena simplify. Alright. Now, kalau kita nak darab ke sini, kita dapat 2x negative 1 plus 2. Sebab darab. Kalau bahagi baru kita tolak. Ini kita masukkan dia ke sini pula. Tolak 2x negative 1 plus 1 over x plus 1 equal to gx. Right. Now kita simplify dia. So negative 1 plus 2 equal to 2x minus negative 1 plus 1 equal to
0.
0. So contoh kalau kita tulis dalam kalkulator x power 0, dia akan dapat 1. Itu adalah bukti yang itu adalah 1. So 2x minus 2 over x plus 1 equal to gx. Jawapan dia apa? Ayat-ayat. Set. Kita tengok jawapan dia. Alright, jawapan dia. Okay. So sebab dia 2 kat luar. So kita kena keluarkan 2 ni. So kita keluarkan 2 ni dengan 2 ni. Kita keluarkan ke kiri. Contoh kalau dia ada sama nombor, kita boleh keluarkan ya. Okay. So 2x minus 1 over x plus 1 equal to gx. So the answer would be A. Okay, betul. Okay. Now I'm going to explain how to do two question which is pretty similar, but it's not, there's different way to do it. Dia ada question macam ni. Find fx. Okay. Soalan A. Fx. Sorry. Fx. G fx. Ni A. Yang B pula. Soalan tengok lah. F G X. Ah, okay. Equal to something, equal to something. Nah, kita tengok position fx dia. Fx ni kat dalam. Oh, sorry. Right. Fx ni kat dalam. Yang ni fx dia kat luar. Right. Untuk pelajar yang tak ambil admat waktu dulu, waktu SPM dulu, dia ada cara dia untuk jawab. Contoh kalau fx kat dalam, kita kena cari inverse. So g f negative 1 x equal to gx. Contoh kalau b pula 1. Contoh kalau b pula arrow, tak nak macam arrow. Ah. Contoh kalau b, kita kena masukkan nilai dia. Contoh if fx equal to x plus 1. So sebab gx kat dalam, kita kena letak gx plus 1 equal to something. So kita kena express gx. Ah, itu cara dia. So dia ada dua cara dan you need to remember this correctly.
Very helpful.
Very helpful. Alright, ada satu lagi soalan. Tapi saya kena cari dulu. Dia ada dari Instagram, tak silap. What's set. Ah, ni dia. Sekejap ya. Set. Ni. Alright, and also to remind you guys, soalan graf akan keluar berapa persen. Tapi rasanya lebih kurang 3-4 soalan tu lah. Jadi memang kena betul-betul conquer. Hafal, conquer benda tu. Okay. Oh,
gila. Sekiranya LVV. Ni one tu.
Ah, tak ada je. Ah. Alright, now. Kita zoom. Okay. So, kat sini, dia kata information dia. Dia kata domain is equal to 3 infinity. Jadi maksudnya domain dia berada pada, domain ni maksudnya x. Okay, domain ni maksud dia x. So 3 dan infinity. This is x axis. Okay. And then dia kata lagi range equal to negative infinity to infinity. Maksudnya dia tak ada limit. So this is why. So dia tak ada limit. Tapi 3 ada limit. So dia kena titik. Okay. So when x equal to 5, y equal to 0. When x equal to 5, y equal to 0. So itu adalah y intercept. x equal to 5, y equal to 0. This is x-intercept. X-intercept. Okay. Alright. And then when x approaching 3, y is negative infinity. Contoh kalau positive infinity, dia dari atas. Contoh kalau negative infinity, dia dari bawah. When x approaching positive infinity, maksudnya dia ke sini. Y is positive infinity, maksudnya dia ke sini. So graf dia akan lebih kurang macam ni lah, fizik. Y, x. So jawapan dia A. To explain further, contoh kalau graf B, dia supposed to be, contoh kalau graf dia punya range dia sama, cuma when x approaching 3, y is approaching positive infinity sebab dia ke atas. Yang ini dia ke bawah. Okay. And then dia punya, when x is approaching positive infinity. Y is approaching infinity. Why? Oh, sorry. Y is approaching negative infinity. Negative infinity. All right. So, that's all for me. Ashraf.
Jawapan dia A.
All right.
Continue.
Sekejap, soalan apa lagi?
Sekejap, aku sing kat hang.
Sekejap, mana
Pak? Apa-apa boleh tanya dekat Twitter suruh dia, okay?
Okay, boleh sing kat hang. Atau, oh aku boleh ambil kat suruh dia je. Okay, mana pen?
Alright. So, yang ni pun soalan daripada Twitter. Kami main kutik-kutik.
kalau tak dapat tu sorry ya.
Ya, banyak pertanyaan. Kami otak limited, dua je. Sorry ya kawan-kawan.
Seru dia ada tiga.
Alright, so this is the question. Kita buat bawah sikit, okay. Sekejap, kurang saiz sebenarnya. Kurang saiz dulu.
Makan.
Okay. Eh, Syed. Ini kan soalan yang baru buat.
Oh, ni dah buat.
Ya Allah.
Syed, kita cari soalan yang lain.
Cari soalan yang lain. Oh, ni hang. Mana aku? Oh, ni. Kita ambil soalan ni. Soalan ni agak...
mencabar.
Tengok soalan ni start mengucap lah cepat-cepat.
Yeah.
Very... dia...
rasa saya guna calculator pun tak boleh.
Kan? Dia next level lah.
Anda tiada jalan keluar. Tapi kalau tak boleh tu janganlah buat bagi kosong.
Kan? Jangan je tinggal jawapan. At least... hentam tu... entahlah sekian apa ada jawapan tu. So anyways, lama duk ajak orang hentam pula, edih lah.
Tidak, maksudnya contoh kalau dah desperate.
Ah ya, ada desperate. So kita tengok soalan ni. So first dia duk bagi function hx dalam sebutan fx kuasa 3. And then dia ada bagi nilai fx if the domain is either a or yang ni kalau dia f differentiate. No ah, yang ni dia ada tanda, so kena be careful. Do not apa tercuai di situ. Yang ni tak sama dengan yang ni. Tengok nilai pun memang tak sama kan. Jadi yang ni ialah f yang kita differentiate dan ni f yang biasa. Alright. So kita tulis dulu maklumat apa yang kita dapat tadi. So jangan panik, tulis jawapan, tulis maklumat yang dia bagi. Dia bagi HX. Kita zoom sikit. Okay. HX is X kuasa 3. F X kuasa 3. Okay, yang ni. So, comma, dia bagi maklumat yang F 8 equals to 5. F tanda 8 equals to 1. And dia also minta kita cari H tanda 2. So, how do we do this? So, first, what we must do is we have to differentiate H ni dulu. So, kalau dia bagi contoh H tanda, dia bagi HX kan? Jadi, kita differentiate lah. So, how do we differentiate this, guys? For those who are watching, I'm awake and alive. Bagus. So, cara kita differentiate ni, yang ni nampak tak hubungan dia darab kan? Jadi, kita kena use the product rule, right? So product rule yang you adakah dia sudah hang?
Masalah teknikal.
Sebab phone jalan-jalan dia internet slow lah. Tak tulis je.
Oh tak, laptop hang.
Laptop hang ah?
Ha.
Shoot. What should we do?
What should we do? I guess that's the end of it. But we are still live. Well, if we tersekat, then nice to meet all of you. If not, what to do? Tak tahu lah. If we tersekat, then if we cancel, then just go to my channel, then we see you over there. Okay, if anything happen, go to YouTube, Rodi Rejab, then we continue from there. Ada beberapa soalan tak habis settle lagi, we try to continue. Are we still here? Okay, we still here. Okay. Yeah, sorry, what to do? Computer mah. Alright. So ada soalan settle lagi. Tak show screen ni.
Alright, sorry technical difficulties back there. So we basically have to find the derivative of hx. So ni dia guna product rule lah. Basically u v tanda plus v u tanda ni. So just input the value x kuasa 3 more x kuasa 3. Ni kalau kita nak apa differentiate function, we just do this. So kita buat kurungan besar dulu. Besar sangat ni. So ni f tanda x kuasa 3. And then sini we differentiate the bracket. Alright. So untuk yang ni pastikan faham benda ni sebab apa mana tahu keluar PSPM ke, we don't know. So we just have to know that this is how we differentiate a function lah. So we just take the derivative of the function and then just differentiate the bracket of it. So, sini kita just tambah apa? Tambah fx kuasa 3. Kita differentiate ni, kena dapat apa, Eddie? Mana?
Fx power 3. Fx.
Ya. Bagus, Eddie.
Lon.
Tak ada lon. Okay. So, dia nak h inverse, bukan h inverse, sorry. Dia nak apa, yang derivative h ni, kita input value 2. So kita just tulis di sini H2. 2 kuasa 3.
Kelas kita.
F inverse. Bukan F inverse. Sorry. Ini F. F derivative. Itu dia. Sekali sebut tak boleh lari dah. 2 kuasa 3. 3, 2 kuasa 2. Tambah F. 2 kuasa 3. 3, 2, kuasa 2. Alright. So ini faham tak? Ni kita just input value. Ini kita guna x ni. Kita input value dia. So ni kita input value dia sini. Everywhere. Okay. So we'll simplify this equation. 8. Okay, kita ambil color lain sikit. Kita dapat 8 bracket. Ya. Segi tak jelas.
I
Alright. Advice lah. Okay.
We need to use mask.
Ada
bau. Sama kentut. Never mind.
So.
Okay. So satu, Susi ni tiga darab empat berapa AD?
Tiga darab empat,
12. 12, bagus. So ni just tambah. Ni F8 dapat berapa? Tadi kita kira F8 dapat 5. Alright. Lepas tu yang ni kira dapat 12. Okay. Go AD. Ke klik.
Sorry.
Okay.
Integriti so tu salah.
Eh, betul lah.
Satu lima enam. Satu lima enam. So jawapan dia tak lain tak bukan B.
Ini nice lah soalan ni. It's nice gila lah.
Betul.
Okay, I want to do one question.
Alright, go sir.
Okay, nak mengomen sikit. Because bukan mengomen teruk lah. Just someone ask question. I think I should have told her first before I show. Mana message request? Aku tak ingat. Oh, ini. Hai. Ini tanggap. I didn't really want to continue with question. I just want to comment a little bit. Macam mana tadi ada lecturer ngamuk.
Ngamuk.
No, not you. Yeah. No, this question. This question looks very, very innocent. Dengan bunga-bunga dah cantik-cantik, ya. Okay, sent by Zal from Twitter. Hi Zal, you're Mr. Lucky Diva. Sent by Zal. Menarik sikit kan. So tak nak sembang banyak. I just want to tell a bit. You can actually differentiate macam biasa, which means like macam kita buat U over V kan. Boleh tak ada masalah pun. Kita buat U over V, quotient rule dan product rule. Boleh je. Tapi jawapan dia sial. I'm not gonna tapis there. Okay, jawapan dia sial and you won't get the answer. Okay, so the best way to proceed, yes, is to proceed by partial fraction. So you can about fx is A over 2x minus 1 plus B sebab dia squared. Sorry. Tak ada lagi ya? Entahlah. So tadi check Wolfram sebenarnya. You kena buat partial fraction dulu and then baru you differentiate. Okay. The thing is, I argue with the senior lecturer. Yes, soalan ni saya bawa kepada senior lecturer. My sifu KMBP, Mr. Leong. I said, kenapa nak buat partial fraction? Sebab atas ni, derivative dia kurang. I mean, dia punya x tu satu, bawah tu x tu dua. So technically, tak perlu pun buat partial soalan ni. And dia pun agree. Dia kata soalan ni saja nak buat sial ke orang. I mean, dia kata, the senior lecturer said, I should not say his name just now. he said that, kalau nak test derivative cukup lah. Kenapa nak test partial dan derivative? Kalau kau nak buat test partial dan derivative, you should, the soalan ni, bukan marah kat you, okay? Soalan ni patut beritahu buat partial fraction dulu and then buat derivative. So, we can consider this question, sial kau kan. dah lah, partial tak masuk kan. So, I'm not going to go further with this question lah. Okay, so hopefully you understand. You kena buat partial dulu then derivative. Nak keluar tak pas dalam exam nanti? Tak lah, most likely no lah. And agak kejam lah. Kalau, you can do both. You can differentiate dulu and then dapat jawapan and then you buat partial dia dapat jawapan juga. But you get two different answers lah. Kalau buat partial dan dapat jawapan, if I'm not mistaken, jawapan dia A. So check dengan Wolfram calculator online.
komputer, saya guna komputer dia bagi multiple jawapan. And both of them are acceptable, but sial lah soalan ni. Okay, I think that's good. Any other question you want to continue? Ada soalan tak? Okay, tak ada. Then tak ada, ada soalan sendiri. Dah habis dah kah? Jadi, apa nak buat ni? Ajak lah. Tak ada. Tak mahu. Tak ya? Tak senang ajak soalan lain. Tak ada, kita tengok dulu. Ada soalan lain tak? Okay, so dah, I think done good. Tak ada request kan? Ada request lagi tak? Dia kot. Tengok Instagram pula. Okay, while we are here, you can ask questions if you want to.